Hi everybody. So in this video, we are going to perform some performance benchmarking between two reputable Wasm interpreter or JIT or just in time compiler. So one of which is called Wasmer, which kind of famous and reputable. It has been used in a wide range of applications. If you are active in Wasm and writing code, for example, using Rust to export your code as a Wasm binary in order to make cross-platform type of portable basically code, you more or less probably heard about that. The other one, which is a little bit brand new, is a bit newer. I mean, it's not that much new. It's for a couple of years ago. It was a few years ago. It's called Wasmtime. But there has been a trend around that, and many people talk about it. I personally use it for some projects. And Wasmtime claimed that it actually provides better performance, runtime performance, in comparison with Wasmer and the other ones. And also it provides better security. So in this video, I'm trying to make it short and as simple as possible everybody can actually have some takeaway from that. We are going to use the Fibonacci algorithm in a recursive mode because it requires a lot of computations. And based upon that, we are writing a code in Rust, and then we test both Wasmtime and Wasmer to see which one is better. So let's do that. All right, so now let's get started with writing some piece of code and see how these WebAssembly compilers perform. So what I'm going to write right now is a simple Fibonacci algorithm, which actually is kind of computational intensive algorithm here, and it can help us to have better picture about the performance of the compilers. So I use cargo, make a new program, I call it Fibo, and then we go to Fibo. I bring up, I use basically VSC for my coding stuff. Okay. So I just make a simple function. I call this Fibo or Fibonacci, and then we have some input. We call this N, and the type of that is U32. It also return U32 as output, and this is the type of output. And then we say, okay, if n was smaller than 2, then return 1, and else just return, or we can just skip return and just type the function name. Fibo n minus 1 plus Fibo n minus 2. So that's all we need. We just need to invoke that. Say Fibo, and we give a number to that. So I just intentionally give a big number. I would say, but let me put it in the print line. So print line. And here it's gonna be like Fibo, let's say 42. All right, so now let's compile our code. I build the code and basically run that in the native binary in order to get the maximum speed. So I don't use the cargo run, I use build, and then I use that with this command to say, okay, I need to release code, the final code, not debug code. Okay, and now I'm gonna execute my code. It's called Fibo. So we got the number, all right? So now first see what is the performance on the native binary, you know, on our machine. And then it gives us better, you know, understanding about the overhead in WebAssembly in general and between those compilers. So I use time, and then I run this again. So as you can see, this is our result here. All right, guys, so now we have the, you know, overall picture about the native code performance and how it works on the basically native machine without using WebAssembly and so forth. So now we are going to compile it to WebAssembly code. And in order to do so, we use cargo again, cargo build, and then we have release. And this time we use extra switch. We specify a target, and target gonna be Wasm 32. And WASI, which is the Cisco interface. So we have WASM 32 and dash WASI, and it should give us basically the binary, the WASM code. So now at the moment, okay, cool. So now if I go in target, I see another folder, WASM WASI. So here I can see my WASM, you know, binary or WebAssembly binary here. So what I'm going to do, first I want to run that on Wasmer. So in order, if you don't have Wasmer, I mean, I do have it here. If you don't have it, you can simply use brew install Wasmer. If you use Mac, if you don't use Mac, you can take a look at the description below, and I put the code over there, and you can use kernel and just download and use that on your Linux machine, etc. And by the same token, you can also use Wasmtime, or you can just take a look at this website. So anyway, so first we are going to use Wasmer and run that on Wasmer to see how it works. So I use time here, then I set Wasmer, and then I specify target, then release, and then FIBO. All right. So this is what we get in terms of CPU, if you compare that with what we have here. So let's actually put this stuff somewhere. I'm gonna make a file. And I put the result over here. So for the targets, is this one. And then for Wasmer, here's this one. And now it's time for Wasmer. So for Wasmer, we just change here to Wasmtime. And there we go. Take a look at the performance, overall performance, and the time that requires to compute the Fibonacci for the input number of 42. We can see on the native code when we have Rust code and we compile that to LLVM, and then finally we get optimized machine code, we would have 0.8 the time that takes on the machine to calculate Fibonacci 42. Whereas when we use Wasm or WebAssembly and then use Wasmer, it takes 1.05. And when we use Wasmtime, we get 0.96. So as you can see, for this round, Wasmtime gain a better performance, runtime performance here. But now let's repeat that a few more times, or one more time, and to see and make sure about our result, okay? So first I just do it again with the normal machine. So I got 80 again, as you can see. And now I'm gonna run that with Wasmer. This time I got 98, a little bit better result this time. And if I do this with Wasmtime, then again I get 92, a little bit better. You know, it's because the dynamic of your operating system, your machine, you know, what's going on behind the scene and things like that, you know, about your CPU task at the time. So that's why when you're doing, you perform some sort of benchmarking, writing papers or doing some analysis, you got to do it in a loop and do this for a number of different time. So let's do this again with Wasm. This is with the target again. So we got 80, doesn't change that much. When we do this with Wasmtime or Wasmer first, this time we get 1.05, and if we do this with Wasmtime, we got 90. So as you can see, it's just, we have overall better performance in Wasmtime. So of course we can try various code here and see the outcome. Based on our basically short comparison here, we can see actually Wasmtime, it seems apparently provide a better performance. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you find it useful, please don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to my channel, and also write down your comments. And you can also follow me on GitHub, on Twitter, on Medium, you know, and other places. Okay, thank you very much for your time, and see you soon. Bye.